Hello and welcome to Joey Moss School Open House video. We're so glad that you're here to join us and learn a little bit more about our school and our wonderful community that we're going to build. We start by acknowledging that we are in Treaty 6 territory, a traditional meeting grounds, gathering place, and traveling route to the Cree, Soto, Blackfoot, Métis, Dene, and Nakota Sioux. We acknowledge all the many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit whose footsteps have marked these lands for centuries. Well, welcome. My name is Mrs. Marshall, and I have the privilege of being the principal of Joey Moss School. So I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I have 25 years of experience with Edmonton Public Schools. Prior to this position, I was the principal at Michael A. Kostick School, and before that, Ormsby School. Prior to that, I was the assistant principal and curriculum coordinator at George H. Leck. I've had the privilege of teaching in many Edmonton Public School divisions, and I even taught in two school divisions in Saskatchewan. Well, a little bit about our namesake. I think Joey Moss is a name that we all know and recognize. Joey definitely left a legacy in the heart of Edmontonians, and we are just so proud to remember his passion, his positive attitude, and his incredible work ethic. He taught people about acceptance and inclusivity through his work and community involvement. A little bit about our school. We are built around the 21st century design principles. This means that we have comfortable, welcoming learning spaces. We focus on safety and comfort. We have modern furniture, flexible designs that accommodates all learning styles and needs. The design allows for lots of movement, and it really focuses on community and collaboration. And we believe that this design will really support students' overall health and well-being. Here's some photos of 21st century design in other Edmonton public schools. You see comfortable furnishings, you see lots of different tables and places where students can gather in small groups or large groups. Here is our school, Joey Moss. You can see construction is well underway. It's a really modern school design. It has beautiful, bright, open learning spaces and lots of big windows in every classroom. We're fortunate to have two gyms, and the design also has a music room, an art room, two science rooms, a beautiful foods lab, and we're adding in a fitness room. The students on the main floor, kindergarten to grade 5, will have individual cubbies, and the students upstairs, our grade 6s and junior highs, will have lockers. And the construction is set to be completed by the end of July, so we look forward to that. Our library learning commons will really be a focus of our school. We are committed to providing students with many opportunities to enjoy quality literature, and our goal is to develop a love of reading. A privilege of a new school is we have the opportunity to create a space for students to learn and grow. We believe that every child is unique and special, and we value them. Our goal is to program for individual student needs. We know that we're going to have students that need challenge, and we're going to have students that need support. And our goal is to meet them where they're at and help them on their learning journey. We will focus on relationships and ensuring students feel connected to their school and their peers. So, how we're going to support our students? Our real focus is going to be on literacy, as we feel that's a building block to all other learning. And all of our classrooms will have daily guided reading. Our writing program will focus around the writing workshop approach, and we're building a strong home reading program for our kinders to grade 3. In our numeracy work, we'll focus on guided math and our small group instruction. Students will have the opportunity to learn through manipulatives, and we'll focus on understanding math concepts. At Joey Moss, we're really considering the whole child, and this will allow us to provide them opportunities for physical activity every day, opportunities in the arts, and opportunities with inquiry, where children will learn to question and wonder and guide their own learning to explore these wonders. Enrichment for students is going to be another focus at our school. And this year, we have already booked two artists in residence for our students. The first one is the visual arts. And every student in our school will be painting a tile, and the tiles will all fit together to make a beautiful mosaic for our library learning commons. Our second artist in residence will focus on dance. And we have Dance Ed Movement Project coming in for a two-week dance residency in January, and then a showcase for all of our families. Please note that there will be an arts fee to help support these residencies. And now let's chat about junior high options. For the first year, grades 6 and 7 will both be part of the junior high options. We have a variety that we're planning for, but in the first week, we're going to survey students and check in on their interests and needs, and at that time, determine what the options will look like. Students will move through the options with their learning group and their class. And we're also considering junior high enrichment for our grades 6s and 7s. So we have booked a fall, a winter, and a spring-summer outdoor learning activity where students can challenge themselves and learn some new skills. We're also working in development with the Winifred Stewart Association and the Joey Moss Foundation on how we can provide leadership opportunities for our students and how they can be involved in our school community. Well, building school spirit is so important in a new school and in all schools, but we're excited to have a plan on how we're going to build school spirit. In collaboration with our parents, we will offer hot lunches to students. We will have monthly theme days where students can dress up and show their school spirit. We'll be offering a variety of clubs for all of our students. We're also planning to have a strong intramural program for our Division 2 and 3 students. Our junior high students will have the opportunity to participate in sports teams, and we're going to be designing some Joey Moss swag that our students can purchase so that they can wear and show off their school spirit. We have two attendance areas. Our primary attendance area is Keswick, and our secondary is Keswick Southwest. If you live in those areas, then Joey Moss is your school, and we welcome you. Next year, we're opening up as a kindergarten to grade 7 school. The year after that, we'll offer grade 8, and then we'll offer grade 9. So we will grow into our K to 9 school. For getting to school, there is no school bus for our kindergarten to grade 7 students. Our hope is that our families will be walking to school and biking to school since the school is right in the community. If you live in Keswick and you have children in grades 8 or 9, they will be able to get yellow bus service to attend S. Bruce Smith School. So we're currently in our pre-enrollment and registration. If you're already in Edmonton Public Schools, then you just need to go through School Zone and pick your school choice for next year. Remember, pre-enrollment closes April 14th at 4 p.m. If you're new to Edmonton Public Schools, then you register online at epsc.ca. So we hope that our families are ready to get involved and join the school community. You can start by following us on Instagram. In August, your School Zone account will switch over to Joey Moss, so you can check our School Zone account and our school website. We have already started to put dates on our school calendar, which is on our website and on our School Zone. You'll also be able to order your student school supplies through those platforms. We hope that you talk to your children and prepare your child to join a new school and prepare them for all the new people and experiences that they will get to be a part of. Parents will have the opportunity to join our parent groups, and of course, we'll be working together and building a playground committee, and we hope the whole community will work with us to support our playground fundraising so we can get a playground built for our students to enjoy. Well, we hope you keep in touch. Our next step will be to staff for the school. Once we get the staff in place, we'll pick a time to have a meet and greet. We hope you follow us on Instagram, check out our new website, and of course, email us if you have any questions at all. Thanks again for joining us, and we look forward to seeing everybody in September. Take care.